You have observed the dynamics of a Bucks in Montgomery County 2020. Is it the same as 2016?
No, I've got to say, 4 years later, there was this discernible drop among, and we've all heard this handicapping among suburban women in Bucks in Montgomery County. Yet, Donald Trump, as we know, he's a fierce campaigner and made up for that reduction in the suburban counties across Pennsylvania, because I believe Democratic women in many, many rural hustings, many rural locations, went with Donald Trump to make up for that. But now, as we've already observed, it moves from the voting machines to a judicial courtroom.
You and Tom Ridge went up against Ed Rendell, and of course, that's the power politics of Philadelphia. There's Pittsburgh as well. Are we going to see the same polarized Biden support in Philadelphia, in Pittsburgh, that we observe in Detroit and Milwaukee?
My sense is that the election platform in Philadelphia is essentially a safe and valid one. Yet that jurisdiction, and for that matter, every other county in Pennsylvania, has never been through this large influx of write-in ballots. So even with the best of intentions, they've got to be monitored as far as the accuracy of the vote. And I'm sure that both the Biden campaign forces and the Trump campaign forces will be making moves this morning immediately to monitor that process. Because as we see in Michigan or in Wisconsin, and particularly dramatically so in Pennsylvania, large number of write-in votes, write-in ballots. It's going to take a long time to get to a conclusion. So to me, that's got to be monitored. And I think it's going to be done safely.